That was lovely, lads.
You're so welcome.
Aren't
you?
No one else.
Just you. We are all go.
Welcome to the channel. I'm here with James Mcbain, aka Hellripper. How you doing?
I'm okay.
Yeah. This is the first date of your tour, yeah?
I mean, it's just a two-gate thing. We're playing Newcastle tomorrow.
Yeah.
Glasgow tonight.
And then where do you go after that?
Just home.
Oh, just back home?
Back up to the Highlands.
Right. So, I have a few questions for you. And then I have a few questions from some subscribers, so we'll kind of intersperse their questions with my questions. Should be groovy. Now, I had never heard of Hellripper until you guys were announced to play at Rover the opening night.
Yeah, Ignition.
So I had no idea what you guys were. gave you guys a listen. It was awesome. How would you describe Hellripper to someone who's never heard it before?
I mean, I usually call myself black speed metal.
Yeah.
But I guess it's anywhere between Motorhead, Metallica. Depends who you're describing it to. If someone that doesn't know about metal, whatever, you just say, set up Motorhead, Metallica. You know what you want about toxic holocaust, Metalhead, Dark Throne, Sagitt. Yeah. So.
I mean, midnight.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate.
Yeah.
We probably should have organized it better.
Cool. Right, I'm going to go to one of the fan questions. And right, let's see what we got here. We got Blacktail Kitty 69. It's a strange name. Is asking, is it true that on a gap year to Australia you overheard a man fart, and his friend replied, "That's a hell of a river," and that's how you got the band name?
That's exactly what happened.
Yeah.
Exactly what happened.
I mean, Blacktail Kid 69, you got that a strange way to get a band name. Cool.
But yeah, the band name doesn't really mean anything. Just keep on with it. It's like a dude in my head.
Yeah. All right. Well, you know, the fans out there.
Yeah.
So it started, or it is, a one-man project. Are you able to play all the instruments?
Yeah, I do that in the studio, in my bedroom. I mean, it's a drum machine, so...
But you program the drums?
Yeah, so I do everything that's in the studio. I get a few of my friends to guest vocals, guest guitar solos and stuff like that, but other than that, it's just done by myself. It's like, since it's a hobby, it's like something I can do, I don't have a deadline to do anything, I just do what I want to, I can take as long as I want, and so I enjoy working out better. I can write new musicians, but the reason it is a one-man band is just because I can find anyone at a time to be in a band with me, so I just want to do it myself.
So there's not many people out there that have
a band? Well, there is now. I mean, I was 18 or 19, so I wasn't really involved in the scene, so I didn't know anyone really.
Yeah.
So I just got I just have to do it myself. And then I met people after I got more involved in the scene. But yeah, everything's still done since the start of the studio, it's just doing myself.
So how do you choose who will play with you on live dates then?
Hell, we're usually just friends.
Just you at this
point? Yeah. I started off just asking friends. Joseph, our current guitarist, he was a guy from Aberdeen that I knew he was an indie band for a hard few years before. And he had purchased merch from me before, and I just asked him if he was a band. And Max, the current drummer, he's actually based in Brighton. So he's like, that's where I was on the end. His friend, Oscar, is a fan of the band, and I think he passed on a message to him, and Max just messaged me randomly, and he sent a video of him playing one song, so he was, within one day, two or three songs. It's usually just friends, and it's just a lot of fun.
Right, we'll go back to some fan questions. Cult Leader 69.
I don't know if I've got 69.
Weird app. He's asking, are you just the fourth member of Midnight playing Midnight B-sides?
I mean, you'd think it's Midnight B-sides, but it's actually original material.
Original material.
No, there's only three members of Midnight, so.
True.
Got it wrong. Clearly not a fan. So you've just signed to Eastville.
Mm-hmm.
How's that going to actually help the band, or at least you, for the future?
With Peaceville, I mean, obviously it's a well established, like recognized name, at least. Basically, the distribution will be better. Hopefully, it brings us like an air of legitimacy.
Yeah.
Like a professional band. Yeah, just. I think it can be our name to more people. The album should hopefully be available in more places like international distribution and promotion and marketing and stuff. So. I expect to.
Like, considering I'm a massive fan of Hellripper, and you've played Commission by, to me, that's like, oh, you've clearly reached godlike status. But what to you would be the pinnacle for
Pinnacle? I mean, I just want to keep growing until we can grow anymore. I mean, I don't know how far as possible. I mean,
like communism. Want to spread.
Exactly. That's exactly what I was about to say. That's exactly about what I was going to say. No, yeah, hopefully, just, I mean, I don't really have an end goal. I just want to keep each year, just play a tour, hopefully more people turn up each hour, hopefully it sells slightly more. Yeah, just, I don't really see I don't really have an end goal. It's just, see what happens. Through.
Yeah, so far, so good.
Cool. Well, we'll go back to another question from a fan. Black bass. You would think that, but not this time. Just black bass. Have you heard the Metallica song, Hit the Lights?
Never. I got no words.
I mean, that was the only point. That was just it. He was just wondering.
Did you say
Metallica?
Never heard
of Metallica.
Shit, I mentioned them. It's not. It's gone wrong. It's gone wrong.
Yeah, you got caught in your own trap there. Yeah. So, have you ever thought about just moving down from Aberdeen to
hear the Lowlands?
Well, I've actually moved upwards to Fort Lowland. So I'm in the Highlands now. Yeah, so last year we moved out to Fife, which was quite handy. Closer to Edinburgh, closer to Glasgow, and then we went to the Highlands, so further than we were in Aberdeen.
Ah,
so, yeah, now we've got Max, who's in Brighton, so he's 2 hours away from here. It's going on.
Yeah.
I would like to live probably in Edinburgh, too, it's been fun. Just where there's stuff happening.
Yeah.
Wait, I like it. Up in the Highlands, I like to. So much, but like, it's quiet there, but it's not much going on. It's a distraction to me, but
saying that, distraction wise, like, how do you distract yourself from just constantly writing sick black networks?
That's all I do. I mean, yeah, during the period, people like record whatever, I mean, usually,
what kind of music do you listen to
that
case?
Oh,
Satan's Bitch at 69. Who would have thought?
Since a popular number.
It is, for some odd reason. I have no idea. I don't know if it's gone popular in days. But it says that your music has helped me through dark times. But how do you cope with the fact that the sun one day could see the earth?
It's very unquestionable.
I mean,
it's not an office, started off so well.
It did, did.
Oh, thank you.
I love it.
You're going to die.
Well then, we'll probably just wrap this up now, but do you have anything to say to the fans out there, any positive message?
Sun's going to put to the earth, so that's fine.
Might just stop it again.
I mean, don't do that, because I've come all the way
to
all
this.
It's put right down or everything.
But yeah, check us out.
Bandcamp, Facebook, YouTube, Spotify, Instagram. Whatever, yeah, just type our name in Google and see what you can find.
Yeah.
Thank you for taking the time out this week.
No worries, mate. Cool. Well, thanks a lot, guys, for tuning in, and catch you on the flip side. Cheers.